Hey, gentlemen, I hope y'all are doing well. I pray that your families are doing well and everything's going well. For our final sermon, I chose to do funeral scenario number 3 about Linda, who is a 75-year-old who passed away with complications of diabetes. So here we go. Jesus said, "I'm the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I'm the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore. And I hold the keys of hell and death. Because I live, you shall live also." Friends, we've gathered here today to praise God and to witness to our faith and celebrate the life of Miss Linda. We come together in grief, acknowledging our human loss. May God grant us grace that in pain we may find comfort, in sorrow hope, and in death resurrection. We're truly blessed in times like this to have the Word of God, because it's the Word of God and the Holy Spirit working together that allows us to have peace in times of struggle. Paul says in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13, "We do not grieve death as those who have no hope." We have hope. Linda had hope, and that hope is in Jesus Christ. And so our gathering today is truly a celebration of a life well lived and the hope that we have in Jesus Christ. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we come before you humbly right now, Lord. And I pray, I invite you, Lord, to be a part of this service. Lord, we pray that you would make your presence known beyond a shadow of a doubt, that each and every family member, every friend, Lord, of Linda would feel your presence, that we would know your sovereignty, your goodness, your mercy, and your grace, Lord God. And I'm praying for this family that you would guard their hearts and their minds in Christ Jesus, Father, and that you would give them the peace that surpasses all understanding that only you can give, Father. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Hear now Psalm chapter 116, verses 1 through 15. The psalmist writes and he says, I love the Lord, for he heard my voice. He heard my cry for mercy. Because he turned his ear to me, I will call on him as long as I live. The cords of death entangled me. The anguish of the grave came over me. I was overcome by my distress and sorrow. Then I called on the name of the Lord. Lord, save me. The Lord is gracious and righteous. Our God is full of compassion. The Lord protects the unwary. When I was brought low, he saved me. Return to your rest, my soul, for the Lord has been good to you. For you, Lord, have delivered me from death, my eyes from tears, my feet from stumbling, that I may walk before the Lord in the land of the living. I trusted the Lord when I said, I am greatly afflicted. In my alarm, I said, everyone is a liar. What shall I return to the Lord for all his goodness to me? I will lift up the cup of salvation and call on the name of the Lord. I will fulfill my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his servants. The psalmist writes here in 116 verse 15, this last verse that I read to you, he says, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his servants, or some other versions may say of his saints. But to us, death never seems under any circumstance to be a precious thing. We think of death as an enemy. We think of death as a loss. But the Apostle Paul says, to live is Christ, to die is gain. Today, we acknowledge we have lost a mother, a grandmother, a sister, an aunt, a friend, someone that we love. We think of death in terms of our loss. But because Linda had a relationship with Jesus Christ established by faith, her death according to the word of God was precious in the sight of the Lord. You see, we have a tendency to see things as they appear, but God sees everything as it stands in his eternal order and purpose. The death of a Christian is precious because it provides entrance into heaven. For the person that has given their heart to Jesus Christ, death is a transition from earth to glory. The great Baptist preacher Charles Spurgeon wrote, and he writes this about death. He says, "Death is not death if you know the Lord. It's merely a change of place, a change of state, a transfer from one realm to another. Death is not death if it kills no part of us except that which hindered us from a perfect life. Death is not death if it raises us from darkness to light, from weakness to strength, from sinfulness to holiness. Death is not death if it perfects our faith by sight and lets us behold him in whom we have believed. Death is not death if it rids us of death, if it rids us of fear, of sickness and disease, of sorrow and sadness. Death is not death, for Christ has conquered death for himself and for all those who trust in him." It's extremely hard for us to lose a loved one. We all know that. This is why it's so important that we know what the Word of God says. To live is Christ, to die is gain. And yet in another place, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. The Bible is full of amazing promises to those who believe. Listen to this promise from Revelation chapter 21, verses 1 through 7. The Word of God says, "Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride, beautifully dressed for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, 'Now the dwelling of God is with men, and he will live with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain, for the old order of things has passed away.' He who was seated on the throne said, 'Behold, I'm making all things new.' Then he said, 'Write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true.' He said to me, 'It's done. I'm the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To him who is thirsty, I will give drink without cost from the spring of the water of life. He who overcomes will inherit all this, and I will be his God, and he will be my own son.'" These are powerful words for us. Our God says, "Write this down. Take this to the bank. Make note of this, for it's trustworthy and it's true. Behold, I'm making all things new. No more pain, no more tears, no more suffering, no more sorrow, no more death. For the one who overcomes, this is their inheritance. I will be their God and they will be my child." Death, for those who have faith in Jesus Christ, is not the end. Death releases us from the suffering and pain of this life. In John chapter 16, Jesus is trying to prepare his disciples for the tough times that lay ahead of them. And he says to them in verse 33, he says, "I have told you all these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, for I have overcome the world." Jesus Christ has overcome the world. He has conquered sin and death. That doesn't mean that we're exempt from the troubles of this world, from the pain and suffering that we may endure. It does mean that we can find peace in Jesus Christ in the midst of our trials. Solomon King Solomon writes in Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 14, and he says this, "When times are good, be happy. But when times are bad, consider this. God has made the one as well as the other. Therefore, no one can discover anything about their future." I think what this passage is saying is that we can learn in good times and in hard times. How can we know joy without sorrow? How can we know peace without chaos? There are many things in this life that are hard to understand. But I know one thing for sure. Jesus Christ is the solid rock, and we can make it through any situation because he has overcome the world. Jesus Christ has conquered sin and death. See, Linda knew the truth of Scripture. She had a solid faith in Jesus Christ. She was a woman after God's own heart. It was a life well lived. And today, we celebrate Linda's legacy, and we take comfort knowing that she has crossed over, not from life to death, but from death to life. Let's pray.